Hello guys, and welcome back to another video. Now today I'm going to be doing something else. I'm going to be doing great building reviews of Forge of Empires. Now, as you can see, the first great building we're going off to is the observatory. Now this is quite a unique great building, as you can only obtain the blueprints from contributing into other people's observatories. Now, and you can also get blueprints from special events. Now the construction cost is really easy. It's just 10 of every Bronze Age goods. It's a 3x3, which is quite small. Yeah, it's the second smallest great building, I think. Oh my god.
Gone, gone, gone. We have to fight.
Weirdos. And now, now what the observatory does is it gives guild goods, it automatically gives it to the treasury and guild support pool. Now this guild defense like stuff. Now this is very useful for GVG as it gives out a lot of guild support pool, as you can see. 100 at level 10? I mean, what? Now the second great building we're going to is the Temple of Relics. Now this is also quite a unique great building, as the blueprints can only be obtained from Guild Expedition and contributing. Now the construction cost is really easy, it's just Iron Age goods. And the size is a 6x6. Now, what the Temple of Relics does is it gives you access to relic hunt. Now, the more, the higher the Temple of Re
Gone.
the higher the Temple of
Have to fight for
the higher the Temple of Re oh my god, the higher the Temple of Relics is, the more chance you get access to relic hunts, and the more chance it's a rare relic hunt. Now these are the common, these are the uncommon, and these are rare. Now the next great building we're going off is to the statue of Zuesi. Oh my god. Now the statue of Zeus is a great building. Great building, because guess what it does? Only needs a bit of Bronze Age code, so I bet you can afford that. And it gives it military boost. I mean, this can make your army stronger. A level 10, 30 attack and
It's gone.
defense. No, not you, dog. 30 attack and defense. That's crazy. I suggest you have this great building. Now the next one we're going to is the Tower of Babel. Now the Tower of Babel is a 4x4, I believe. Yes, it is. It needs Bronze Age goods. Quite right. I think it's all right because it gives population and goods. Now the amount of population and goods is not so great, but if you want it, then have it. It's optional, it's up to you. But I don't suggest having it unless you're a low era. Now the next one we're going to is the, what's it called again? The Colosseum. Now the Colosseum. The Colosseum is not a great building. It's absolutely terrible. Its construction causes Iron Age goods. But it's huge. It's absolutely huge. I mean, the amount of happiness it gives and the amount of medals, avoid it. I think you should avoid this great building. Now the next one we're going to is the Lighthouse of Alexandria. Now this great building is actually a great building. It only needs Iron Age goods. It's quite small, and guess what it does? Supply boosts and goods. The amount of supply boost it gives is insane.
About Earth is gone. 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 Gone.
Again. And you look like your dog. So basically, it gives an insane amount of supply boost. I suggest you have this great building. Now, the next one we're going to is the Cathedral Cathedral of Aachen, of Aachen, whatever you want to call it. It's a 4x6. It needs early Middle Ages goods, and it produces coins and military boosts. I mean, it's like the statue of Zeus. Same amount of military boost. You definitely need that.
To
Oh,
fight for,
it's dog again.
I mean you, so it's time.
That's a win-win. I suggest you have this. Not you, Jenny. Now, the next one we're going to is the Hagia Sophia. Now, the Hagia Sophia, not really that good. It needs a 7x6. So it's huge and it needs loads of early Middle Ages goods. Now, the Hagia Sophia gives happiness and one forge point per two levels. And oh my god, this door!
To fight for.
And one forge point per two level. I mean, I don't really suggest having this great building because the amount of forge points it gives. Like at a level 10, it gives 6. Not really that good. Okay. Now, the next one we're going to is Notre Dame. Now, Notre Dame is not really a great building. Not really a good building. Because it needs loads of high Middle Ages goods and it produces happiness and supplies. Now, the amount of supplies it gives is absolutely terrible. I mean, oh my god, oh my god! I mean, at level 10, it produces 7,000 supplies and it produces. And it gives you 3,000 happiness. Even a farm, even an alchemist is better than this. Now, the next one we're going to is Saint Sorry, I have to do this every time, guys. It just didn't work with the cutting and stuff. Okay, so this great building is called Saint Mark Basilica. Now it needs high Middle Ages goods and it's a 6x6. This great building produces goods and money boosts. I mean, 100% at level 1. 10 goods at level 1. This is a great building. Now, next one we're going to is Castle Delmont. Now, what the castle does is it gives. Oh, wait, let me try to find it. Is it needs late Middle Ages goods, not so bad. It produces military bonus and forge points. This is like the highest Sophia, but a lot, and I mean a lot smaller. It needs a 5x5 and it produces military boost. I mean, military bonus and forge points at the same time? Have this great building. Please. Now the next one we're going to is Saint Basil's Cathedral. Now this great, oh my god, what the hell? I said Forge of Empires. Sorry guys. Now this great building needs later Middle Ages goods because it's later Middle Ages. It's a 5x5 and it gives defense, guild support pool, and coins. I personally think you should have this great building. I mean, why not? Now the next great building we're going to is, I don't know how to pronounce it, Franschendthing of Dresden. I don't know how to spell it too. This great building is called Frottetikkelkirchgerdich of Dresden. It needs canal of goods. It's a 5x5 and it produces goods and happiness. Now, beyond level 10. No. Right. So, get up. Let's use this. Oh my god, what the hell? Did you just see that, guys? There's a ghost in my room. So it produces goods and happiness. I think you should have this great building. It's good. It's a great building, not that great. Now the next one we're going to is Deal Car Cat. Oh my god, Deal Castle. Now the Deal Castle, as you already know, is Canile Age, so it needs Canile Age goods. It's a 7x7, it produces medals and military defense and guild support. I mean, it produces medals. Good. Not that good. I think you should avoid this great building. Now, the next one we're going to is Royal Albert Hall. Now, the Royal Albert Hall. Oh my god, why do I keep doing this? Now, the Royal Albert Hall is industrial age, so it needs good industrial age goods. It's a 7x6 and it gives you goods and supply boosts. Just like the lighthouse of Alexandria, but industrial age version. It's absolutely insane. Have this great building. Don't avoid it. Now the next great building we're going to is the capital. Now, the capital, as you already know, is industrial age. So it needs industrial age goods. Now, this great building produces supplies, but not that many. And it produces population. I mean, the population is good, but it's up to you if you want to or not. I suggest you should avoid this great building. The next great building we're going to, not Agario's, is the Alcatraz. Oh my god, who put that there? Now the Alcatraz is progressive era, so it's progressive era goods. It's a 10x7, oh my god, it's freaking huge. But guess what? It produces happiness and military units. Yeah, you heard me right. Military units. I suggest this great building very strongly. Delete all your military buildings in your city and only leave your rogue hideouts. Because if you do, this great building produces rogues in a day. 4 rogues in level 1, which means about 130 rogues in a month. I mean, what? This is insane. Have this great building, please. Now the next one we're going to is Shatter from the Neck. Now Shatter from the Neck is progressive era, so we need progressive era goods. Now it's a 5x6 and it's insane. It gives quest bonuses and money. Now with the quest bonuses, a level 1 it gives you 50%. So if a quest gives you 20%, this will gives you 20 diamonds. This will boost it by 50%, which will make it 30 diamonds. Insane. Absolutely insane. Now, the next great building we're going to is Space Needle. Wait, is it? I'm not sure. Yeah. Now, Space Needle should be it's modern era. And it produces. And produces, I don't know, but it keeps you, but it needs modern era goods. It's a 6x5. It produces loads, a hell lot of coins, and happiness. No. Now what's the next one? Wait, I'm just gonna search modern era. Sorry guys, I wasn't prepared for this. Now, let's see. Now, I'm just gonna keep this up. So it's the Atonium, yeah. The Atonium. Oh. Now, this, as you might already know, is modern era. So it needs modern era goods. Now, this great building gives you guild treasury, like guild goods to the treasury and happiness. I'm not sure if you want this great building, but have if you want. I don't really mind. Now the next great building to honor Posner is the Cape Carnival. Now this great building is postmodern era, so it needs postmodern era goods. It produces, it's a 4x5 and it produces 4 twins. Now, loads of players have this, but I mean, the amount, like, it only gives you forge points. Is that it? Now, loads of players have this because they unlock many levels, like level 71, let's say it produces 71 forge points, which is good. But at low levels, it doesn't give them any forge points. It's not that big though, it's up to you if you want this great building or not. Now the next great building we're going to is the Habitat. Now, the Habitat is, the Habitat is postmodern era, if you might already know yet. So it's postmodern era, so it needs postmodern era goods. Now, this great building produces coins and population. Now, if you want this great building, then have it, but only for one reason: if you're going to change all your residential buildings to Shrine of Knowledges, let's say, then have this great building. But don't rush to get this great building. Now, the next great building we're going to is Innovation Tower Bow. Now the Innovation Tower is contemporary era, so it means contemporary era goods. Now it's a 6x6 and it produces population and forge points. I mean, why the heck do you not want this? I mean, population and plus forge points. This is a must-have great building. Now the next great building we're going to is the Lotus Temple. Is that right? The Lotus Temple. I think it's right. Now the Lotus Temple is contemporary era, so it's contemporary era goods. It's a 6x6 and it produces money and happiness. I think I should have this great building because the amount of happiness and money it gives is quite alright. It's up to you if you want it or not. Now the next great building we're going to is the Dynamic Tower. Now the Dynamic Tower is tomorrow era, so it needs tomorrow era goods. Now it's a 6x5 and its bonus is supplies and aid goods. Now this means whenever you aid 12 people at level 1, you get a random good of the building you motivate or polish. Only one good, 12 times at level 1, and it produces supplies. Now I think you should have this great building. It's a quite alright great building. Now the next great building is the Voyager V1. Now this great building is not that good, and I'll show you why. It's tomorrow era and it's tomorrow era goods. Now the Voyager V1 produces plunder goods and supplies. The supplies is not that great, but the plunder goods. Now this means that you oh my god, what just happened? This means that I forgot what it does. Plunder goods, what does it do? I think the first 3 times you plunder a building, you get a random good of that building's age. Yeah, that's what it means. I don't suggest having this great building. It's absolutely terrible. Now, we're going to the future. Now, the first one great building is going to be the Rainforest Project. Now, the Rainforest Project is the future, and it needs future goods, obviously. Now it's a 6x6, and this great building's insane. It gives a more chance of getting a blueprint when you aid someone and goods. At level 10, it produces 34 goods and 93% chance of finding a blueprint when you aid someone. Insane. This is a must-have great building. Now the next great building we're going to is the Ark. Now this great building is a great 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 building. I personally have it, High Middle Ages, by the way, and I have it because it's very good. It's a 7x5. It produces guild like goods for the treasury, and it has a contribution boost. A level 1 has a 10% contribution boost. Like, let's say, instead of getting 100 forge points, you get 110 forge points. Now, instead of getting 10 blueprints, you get 11 blueprints. That's really good. Yeah. Now, I think this is a must-have great building. So, next, we're going to the Arctic Ordinary. Sorry, I have to do this every time, guys. If you want, then skip some parts. Okay. I can't spell today. So, the Arctic Ordinary is Arctic Future, by the name of it, and it needs Arctic Future goods. Now, it's a 7x7, so it's absolutely huge, and it produces forge points and critical hits bonuses. Now, the chance of having a critical hit is not really good, but I mean, forge points on top of that, this is a must have great building. Now, the next great building we're going to is the Seed Vault. Now, the Seed Vault is obviously Arctic Future and needs Arctic Future goods. It's a 5x6 and it has Helping Hands passive bonus and production bonuses. The amount of supplies it gives is good, but the chance of getting something else by aiding people is not that good. I mean, 2% chance at level 10? Are you nuts? You know, games. So, let's say in the Arctic Future, when you aid someone, there's a 2% chance of getting either coins, supplies, goods, medals, or diamonds. That's a 2% chance. I don't really suggest having this great building. Now, the next great building we're going to is the Gee Statue. Now, the Gee Statue, let's see if I can find it. I can't spell today, seriously. Where is its picture? Where's this picture? No picture? No, so the Gee Statue produces medals and happiness. It's Arctic Future 2, so it needs Arctic Future goods. Now, this great building produces obviously medals and happiness. It's really good. I think you should have it. Now, the next great building we're going to is the Atlantis Museum. Now, the Atlantis Museum just released because it's Oceanic Future, and Oceanic Future just released. Now, this Atlantis Museum, it's Oceanic Future, so it needs Oceanic Future.
See, that's it. See, bye.
I don't think that's a good building. Okay, bye.